Intermittent and chronic anovulation are common in the reproductive years, which is usually between the ages of 12 and 51. However, it most frequently occurs during the time around the first menstrual cycle, i.e. menarche, and around the time of one's last menstruation, i.e. menopause. In this video, we will talk about this disease, anovulation, by answering these questions. What is anovulation? What causes anovulation? Symptoms of anovulation. How's it treated? Can I get pregnant if I have anovulation? What is anovulation? Anovulation, also called an anovulatory cycle, happens when an egg doesn't release from your ovary, ovulation. Ovulation only happens one time during your menstrual cycle. The egg that your ovary releases at ovulation has the potential to be fertilized by sperm and create a pregnancy. Anovulation often happens due to a hormone imbalance. Since multiple hormones contribute to ovulation, there can be many causes of anovulation. Because ovulation is critical to pregnancy, anovulation is a common cause of infertility. What causes anovulation? Anovulation is a complex process that involves a lot of organs, glands, and hormones, so there are a lot of potential causes. Some of these include Polycystic Ovarian Syndrome, PCOS. This is the most common cause of anovulation. PCOS causes women to ovulate irregularly or not at all. Sometimes PCOS is associated with elevated levels of testosterone, which can also cause excessive hair growth and acne. Premature ovarian insufficiency, POI. This occurs when a woman's ovaries fail before she is 40. It's sometimes called premature menopause. Some medical conditions and exposures can cause POI, but for many women, the cause is unexplained. About 5% to 10% of women with POI will conceive naturally and have a normal pregnancy. Hypothalamus or pituitary gland dysfunction. These glands produce hormones that are responsible for ovulation. Anything that interferes with the normal function of these glands, such as a benign pituitary gland tumor, can cause anovulation. Diminished ovarian reserve, DOR. At birth, women have all of the eggs they will ever produce. It's normal for a woman's egg supply to decrease over time. Women with DOR have fewer eggs remaining than normal. This can have medical, surgical, or congenital, present at birth, causes, or it can be unexplained. Women with DOR will produce fewer eggs with fertility treatments, but may still be able to conceive naturally. Functional hypothalamic amenorrhea, FHA. This condition can be caused by stress, excessive exercise, or low body weight. It is sometimes associated with anorexia, an eating disorder. Menopause. This is a naturally occurring decline in ovarian function that happens around the age of 50. Menopause is defined as not having had a period in 1 year. Some women experience other symptoms as well, such as hot flashes, difficulty sleeping, and mood changes. Symptoms of anovulation. Women who ovulate regularly often see signs that occur during each cycle. They may experience the following. Increased amounts of cervical mucus. A drop and subsequent rise in resting body temperature in the middle of the menstrual cycle, around day 10 to 16. Periods that occur regularly. Women with very irregular periods, or who do not see signs of ovulation, may wish to try an over-the-counter ovulation predictor kit. These kits measure levels of hormones in a woman's urine to determine when she is ovulating. A doctor may also be able to test a woman's hormone levels or carry out an ultrasound scan to view the ovaries. Can you have an ovulation and still have your period? Menstruation, or getting your period, happens because an egg isn't fertilized by sperm. When you don't ovulate, there's no egg to fertilize. Because of this medical definition, you technically can't menstruate without ovulating. However, you can still bleed, experience a period, without ovulating. This is known as abnormal uterine bleeding, AUB, or anovulatory bleeding. AUB is uterine bleeding that's irregular and doesn't follow a cycle. Abnormal uterine bleeding is common, approximately 30% of people assigned female at birth, AFAB, experience it at some point in their lives. How's it treated? Treatment for anovulation depends on correcting the hormonal imbalance that's causing it, if possible. In general, lifestyle changes that may treat your anovulation include managing your stress. If your healthcare provider suspects that stress could be causing anovulation, they'll likely recommend trying to limit your stressors and using techniques such as meditation, yoga, or deep breathing to better cope with stress. Maintaining a weight that's healthy for you. If you have obesity, your healthcare provider may recommend trying to lose weight to treat your anovulation. If you have a low body mass index, BMI, your healthcare provider may recommend gaining weight to treat your anovulation. If either of these situations applies to you, be sure to talk to your provider and/or a registered dietitian to manage your weight safely and in a way that works for you. Decreasing your exercise frequency and intensity. If your healthcare provider suspects that your exercise routine and intensity are causing your anovulation, they may recommend limiting the amount of time you exercise and the intensity of the exercises. Other treatments for anovulation include certain medications to treat other conditions. If you have a treatable condition that's causing your anovulation, your healthcare will likely prescribe you medication, which could also treat your anovulation. For example, if you have hypothyroidism, which can cause anovulation, taking medication to treat your hypothyroidism could also treat your anovulation. Adjusting current medications. Some medications can cause anovulation, such as anti-epileptic drugs and antipsychotic drugs. If you're trying to conceive, your healthcare provider might adjust your current medications to try to treat your anovulation, if possible. Never adjust or stop taking your medications without seeing your healthcare provider. Always follow the instructions on your prescribed medications. Clomiphene citrate, CC, this is often the first line of treatment for anovulation. It has about an 80% success rate in helping you ovulate. A common brand name is Clomid. Letrozole, although it's an off-label use, meaning that it's not FDA approved to treat anovulation, but research indicates that it could help treat this condition. Some healthcare providers recommend this type of medication to induce ovulation instead of clomiphene citrate. The brand name for this medication is Femara. Human chorionic gonadotropin, HCG, injection. This hormone causes your ovary to release an egg. Your provider can give you a synthetic form of it through an injection. It's often taken with clomiphene citrate or letrozole. Follicle-stimulating hormone, FSH, injection. If your body isn't making enough FSH and other treatments for anovulation haven't worked, your healthcare provider may have you get an injection of synthetic FSH to help your ovary release an egg. Gonadotropin-releasing hormone, GnRH, agonist and antagonist injections. An injection of GnRH agonists and antagonists helps to control the levels of luteinizing hormone, LH, your body makes, which is needed for ovulation. If fertility and pregnancy are your goal, and lifestyle changes and/or medication don't help to treat your anovulation, there are still ways you may be able to experience pregnancy. Talk to your healthcare provider or a fertility specialist about in vitro fertilization, IVF, or intrauterine insemination, IUI. Can I prevent anovulation? You can't prevent anovulation, but some of the reasons you have anovulatory cycles can be due to things you can manage. Things you can help manage include healthy habits, getting enough sleep, eating nutritious foods, exercising moderately, and managing stress levels can all help you regulate hormones and contribute to overall hormonal health. Tracking your cycles. Keeping records of your cycle length and symptoms can help you identify irregularities. Note things like when you bleed and how much, or if you notice a chance in your vaginal discharge. It's also helpful to have this data for your healthcare provider. Treating hormonal imbalances, treating conditions like PCOS or thyroid dysfunction with medication or other treatments can increase your chances of ovulation. Can I get pregnant if I have an ovulation? Lifestyle changes and/or medication can often treat anovulation, which means you'll have an opportunity to get pregnant. But there are many other factors that contribute to a successful pregnancy. If you're receiving treatment for anovulation and are still having a difficult time getting pregnant, your provider may recommend in vitro fertilization, IVF, or intrauterine insemination, IUI. Thank you for listening to all the information we want to introduce to you in this video. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel.